So it is referred to as the secret mantra, the Vajrayana. And so secret, not because it is intentionally hidden or kept secret, but because it is difficult to understand its meaning. So the Vajrayana, the secret mantra, must be understood by means of signs, symbols, and meaning in these three different ways. For example, the sign of a sword. Manjushri, for example, holds a sword. So a sword is just like an ordinary knife. So a knife, a sword, is used, for example, can be used to kill somebody. So it can be seen as a very bad thing. But also a sword has the quality, this ability to cut anything. For example, if a person is tied up in a rope, it can cut through the rope. So the sword here is the sign. And the symbol, what it symbolizes, is it symbolizes the cutting through the dualistic grasping, the dualistic perception of self and others. And so what it shows is that the meaning is that ultimately self and others do not actually exist. So it shows the meaning of emptiness. And so it shows that we only hold on to a self, and actually there is no self. So it is a sign that shows the meaning of wisdom. Wisdom that realizes that there is no self, that self and others do not actually exist. So that is the meaning that is represented by the symbol and then first the sign. So the sword of Manjushri, for example, has the power to cut through the web of dualistic grasping. So that is the skillful means of the secret mantra. We understand it through signs, symbols, and meaning. And ultimately here, in this case, the meaning is if you realize the perfection of wisdom, you realize that self and others do not exist. There is no such a duality of self and others. So that is, you realize that although you still perceive all the various appearances, the phenomena of samsara and nirvana, but they appear like an illusory plane. They do not appear in a dualistic manner. They appear just like the waves on an ocean. The waves do appear, but they do not appear separate from the ocean. So self and others appear, but they do not appear separate from each other. Or it is just like the appearance of a rainbow light emerging from a crystal. It is not seen as separate from the crystal. So there is no perception of a distinction, a separation between self and other. So that is the seeing everything as illusory. It is called the illusion-like samadhi. It is only that because we grasp, we hold self and others to be true separate realities, it is because we perceive things in this dualistic, impure way, that creates the six realms of samsara. They appear in this way, but they appear just like an illusion. So understanding this, all appearances as an illusion, that is the basis of the Vajrayana, the secret mantra. So things appear, the six realms of samsara, but they appear like an illusion. Because all beings possess Buddha nature. And Buddha nature itself is beyond birth and death. Things only appear due to temporary habitual imprint in their mind. And due to that, some of them appear as animals for as long as they have the karma, and some of them appear as hell beings, or others wander anywhere else in the three lower realms and so on. For as long as they have the particular karma and habitual imprints. But when this karma comes to an end, then still there is Buddha nature, and it hasn't changed at all. Buddha nature is never born and it never dies. It remains continuously. And realizing that, one perceives all other arisings, all other appearances, like an illusory plane. And knowing everything to be an illusion, then there is no fear with regard to whatever appears. So understanding things to be illusory is to understand the actual view of secret mantra. And that is called the illusion-like samadhi. And then due to this illusion-like samadhi, because you understand that ultimately nothing, the nature of mind is never born and it never dies, Then there's also no fear. So that's the second type of samadhi, the hero-like samadhi. There is no fear of death because the mind cannot die. And then that samadhi leads to the vajra-like samadhi, the ultimate realization of Mahamudra. That is to realize the nature of mind, Buddha nature, within which suffering does not exist. It is just like space. And space is never born, it never arises, and it never ceases to be. And there is also no suffering in space. So the nature of the mind, therefore, is great bliss that is free of all suffering. The nature of space never experiences any difficulty, any hardship. And so realizing the nature of mind in this way is referred to in the Nyingma, the old tantric system, as Samantabhadra, and in the Sarma, the new tantric system, as Vajradhara. So it is given two different names that point to the same nature. That is ultimately the nature of emptiness. That is the ultimate nature of secret mantra of Vajrayana. So that is what we ultimately realize when we practice the Vajrayana. And so, contemplating this, we can really see, we can really understand, we can, it can make sense to us that how this can actually be accomplished.